Hey guys, welcome to United Indians e-learning platform. I am Bhuksatak, and the last session, if you remember, we have completed with the Mughal architecture. Okay, we have seen some features of medieval architecture, that is Indo-Islamic architecture. Then we have covered the Delhi Sultanate architecture and Mughal architecture. Okay, so today we are going to cover Sikh style of architecture, after that Rajput style of architecture, and then architecture of Kashmir. So let's begin with the Sikh style of architecture. So this Sikh style of architecture is heavily influenced by Mughal style, and some of its main features are like the use of multiple chhatris or kiosk, one and the same thing on the top of the construction, as you can see in this golden temple, which is also called Harminder Sahib temple at Amritsar. Okay, so these are called chhatris or kiosks, which are used on the top of their construction. So this is the most important feature of the Sikh style of architecture. Okay, then you have use of shallow cornices. Cornices means the corners of the wall. Okay, the joint of the wall, that is, this is the wall and this is the wall. Okay, so these walls are joint. Okay, so to hide this joint, decoration is applied on it. Okay, some architectural decorations are applied on these joint of the wall. So these are called cornices. So the cornices are shallow in the Sikh style of architecture. Then their buildings are having fluted domes, which are generally covered by brass and copper gills for decoration and support. And the arcs were decorated by the use of numerous foliation. So the main thing you need to remember in Sikh style of architecture is that they use multiple chhatris and their cornices are shallow and they use fluted domes. That's it. Examples already I have told you. One of the most important example is the Sri Harmandir Sahib or Golden Temple in Amritsar. Okay, so this the construction of this Harmandir Sahib temple was initiated in 1585 and it was completed in 1604 by Arjun Dev. Okay, remember this, that the construction of Golden Temple, though started in 1585, it was completed in 1604 by Arjun Dev. So this was the Sikh style of architecture. Next is your Rajput style of architecture. Now this Rajput style of architecture is also influenced by Mughal architecture, and some of its features are that they introduce the concept of hanging balcony, which were constructed in all shapes and sizes. And the example for this would be the Hawa Mahal, which is in Jaipur. Okay, so this is your hanging balcony. Hanging balcony as in the window is a little outwards, on outwards side. Okay, the window or the balcony, whatever you say, it is on the outwards side. Like in the picture you can see. So these are the hanging balconies of Hawa Mahal. And the cornices were built in the shape of an arc, such that the shadow took the shape of a bow. If you can see, the joint of the walls were in curvilinear shape. Okay, curved shape, like an arc. Not like the one in the Harmandir Sahib temple, which was rectangular or square in shape, if you can see. In Hawa Mahal, it is curvilinear. From the outside itself, you can judge that. Okay, so this was the basic Rajput style of architecture. So the main thing that they introduced was the hanging balconies, and other things were similar to the Mughal style of architecture that we have done in the previous session. Okay, then let's move on to architecture in Kashmir. So we have a lot of architecture in Kashmir. We have temples, we have mosques, we have dargahs, etc. So let's see. The main features of Kashmir style of architecture are trefoil arcs, okay, which were influenced by the Gandhara's architecture. Then you have cellular layout and enclosed courtyard. Courtyard are mostly open, but in the Kashmir style of architecture, the courtyards are enclosed. Okay, so this was the main feature of Kashmir style of architecture. Then you have straight edged pyramidical roof. We will be seeing all these features in the upcoming pictures. Then you have column walls, which were influenced by Greek architecture. Then you have triangular pediments, which are again influenced by Greek architecture. And they have relatively more number of steps than other types of architecture. So basically what you need to remember in the main features of Kashmir architecture is that it is influenced by Gandhara architecture and it is influenced by the Greek architecture as well. Okay. So let's see temples first of all. First temple that we're going to see in the architecture of Kashmir is Markand Sun Temple. It was established in 8th century AD by the Kakota dynasty. Okay, Kakota dynasty belong to Kashmir, and this Kakota dynasty established or built the Markand Sun Temple. So it have Gandhara influence, it have Chinese influence, and it have Gupta influence as well in its style of architecture. So what's the main features of Markand Sun Temple is that the main temple has a pyramidical top. Okay, pyramidical top. As in pyramid, kaisa hota hai? Stepwise conical shape. Right. So if you see in this picture, you can see the pyramidical shape, the stepwise conical shape. Okay. And carvings of gods like Vishnu, river goddess Ganga and Yamuna, and sun god are there on the walls of this temple. Okay, so Markand Sun Temple belongs to Kakota dynasty of Kashmir. It have Gandhara, Chinese and Gupta influence, and the main temple has a pyramidical top. And it also have a lot of carvings of various gods like Vishnu, Ganga, Yamuna, sun god, etc. Okay. Then next is the temples at Avantipura. There are various temples at Avantipura, but two of them are really famous and important from the exam perspective. That is Avanti Swamin, which is for Lord Vishnu, and Avantiswara, which is for Lord Shiva. Okay, don't get yourself confused between two kinds of temple. Avanti Swamin is for Lord Vishnu and Avantiswara is for Lord Shiva. Now, these two temples were built by King Avanti Varman of Utpala dynasty. Okay, he was the first king of Utpala dynasty, and these temples were built in 9th century AD. And these temples have Roman and Gandhara influence. So you can see that almost Gandhara influence is there in all the architecture of Kashmir. Okay, so this is the picture of the Avanti Swamin temple. Okay, Avanti Swamin is for Lord Vishnu, Avantiswara is for Lord Shiva. Who built these temples? It is Avanti Varman of Utpala dynasty, and it have Roman and Gandhara influence. That's all you need to remember about it. Next is your Pandranath temple. It is also called Meru Vardha Swami, and it is dedicated to Lord Vishnu. But that doesn't mean that it won't have the images of other gods. It do have images of Shiv as well. Okay, though it is dedicated to Lord Vishnu, this temple also have images of Lord Shiva. And the most important feature of this temple is that it is carved out of a single block of stone, as you can see in the picture. Okay, this temple is carved out of a single block of stone. Okay, it is built in 10th century AD and it has a domed roof and arcs. You can see that it has a dome, roof and also arcs. Okay, it is clear in the picture that it is having arcs in the entrance and the roof is domed. Okay, it is not flat. Lintel nahi hai isme. Trebuchet style nahi use kiya hai. Theek hai? Arcuate style use kiya hai. This is the Pandranathan temple. Then, abhi tak humne temples dekh liye. Now, moving on to the architectural development under Islamic rule in Kashmir. सबसे पहला उसमें आ जाएगा आपका जामा मस्जिद. सो इट वॉज कंस्ट्रक्टेड इन द 14th century. इट हैज अ लार्ज कोर्टयार्ड एंड 370 वुडन पिलर्स एंड इट्स कर्व डोम इज नोटेबली एब्सेंट फॉलोइंग द कश्मीरी स्टाइल ऑफ आर्किटेक्चर. ओके, सो यू नीड टू रिमेम्बर दिस थिंग. मोस्टली मॉस्क्स आर एसोसिएटेड विद अ कर्व डोम. ओके, कर्व डोम होता है. कश्मीरी स्टाइल ऑफ आर्किटेक्चर में भी हमने देखा है कि कर्व डोम यूज किया गया है, राइट? पिछले टेम्पल में temple may be curved dome hai, but here in the mosque you won't see a curved dome as usually it is seen in other kind of architecture in Kashmir as well as in the mosque all over India. Jahan pe bhi humne architecture dekha hai mosque ka, mostly we have seen that they have a dome, but here the curved dome is absent in the Jama Masjid of Kashmir. Remember that. Okay, so this is the one architectural development under Islamic rule. Next is your Ali Masjid of Srinagar, and it was built in 15th century by Sultan Hassan Shah. He was a Shahmiri king, and it is one of the largest mosque in Kashmir Valley. Again, absence of dome is here. Okay, and the monument is made of timber and stone. The building has a pyramidal top with arc-shaped windows. Okay, pyramidal top, as we have seen, stepwise conical shape. So, iski building mein जो है डोम नहीं है, डोम की जगह आपको पिरामिडिकल टॉप मिलेगा. फाइन. आफ्टर आली मस्जिद यू हैव दी परी महल. सो दिस परी महल वाज मेड बाय मुगल प्रिंस दारा शिकोह इन मिड 17th सेंचुरी एंड इट इज नियर द चश्मे शाही गार्डन विच ओवरलुक्स द दल लेक. ओके, चश्मे शाही गार्डन जो है दल लेक के पास में, वहीं पे है आपका परी महल. ओके, सो आर्किटेक्चरल डेवलपमेंट अंडर इस्लामिक रूल में हमने तीन बिल्डिंग्स देखी है, जामा मस्जिद, आली मस्जिद एंड परी महल. जामा मस्जिद एंड आली मस्जिद दोनों में ही डोम नहीं है. डोम्स आर एब्सेंट इन बोथ ऑफ दीज मॉस्क, व्हिच इज मोस्टली सीन इन दी मॉस्क इन रेस्ट ऑफ इंडिया और अदर आर्किटेक्चरल बिल्डिंग्स इन कश्मीर एज वेल. द टेम्पल एज वेल वी हैव सीन द डोम इज देयर, बट इन दीज टू मॉस्क, द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट मॉस्क ऑफ कश्मीर फ्रॉम एग्जामिनेशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, जामा मस्जिद एंड आली मस्जिद, देयर इज नो डोम. ओके, देन लेट्स सी द गार्डन्स इन कश्मीर. सो द गार्डन्स वर कंस्ट्रक्टेड इन चार बाग स्टाइल. वी हैव सीन ऑलरेडी के चार बाग स्टाइल क्या होता है. ओके, फोर स्क्वायर्स एंड चैनल्स इन बिटवीन, चैनल्स ऑफ water in between, so that is called charbagh style, four gardens style. Okay, so water streams, fountains and trees form an important part of the gardens. We have already seen that it is a feature of charbagh style which was developed by Mughals. Examples kya hai kashmir ke gardens ke, jaise chashme shahi hai, humne pehle hi padha tha ye, theek hai, chashme shahi jiske paas hai aapka pari mahal. So, Chashme Shahi is the garden which was built around a fresh spring in Persian style. Then you have the Shalimar Bagh which was made by Jahangir. Then you have the Nishad Bagh. Okay. Then you have Badamvari Garden, Verina, Kokernag and Achawal Garden in Anantnag. So these all are the examples of some of the Charbagh style gardens of Kashmir. Okay. Now, Shalimar Bagh mein, some important features, you can see that it have three terraces. First of all, Shalimar Bagh kisne banaya hai? It is made by Jahangir. Okay, Jahangir ne banaya hai ye, and its main features ye hai that it have three terraces. Teen terraces usme, ek terrace hai Diwan-e-Aam, second terrace is the Diwan-e-Khas, and the third one is the Zanana Garden. Alright, Shalimar Bagh ke three terraces hai, one terrace is the Diwan-e-Aam, second terrace is the Diwan-e-Khas, and the third terrace is the Zanana Garden. Zanana means women, garden for women. Okay, important point, please remember this. After that, let's come to temples of Parsis in India. Okay, we have finished with the architecture of Kashmir. So those are all things you need to remember from exam perspective. Now let's come on to the architecture of Parsis in India. So there are three major types of fire temples of Parsis in India. Okay, Parsis ke jo temples hote hain unko fire temple bola jata hai. So basically unke teen type hote hain, three major types of fire temples are there. One is called Atash Behram, that is fire of victory. Second is your Adarian, and third is the Atash Dadga or Dare Mehr. So these three are the major types of fire temples of Parsis in India. Okay, so in India we have eight Atash Behrams. This first one, which is called Fire of Victory, we have three Atash Behram temples and more than 100 Dadgas or Dare Mehr in India, and mostly these are situated in Maharashtra and Gujarat. In Maharashtra also most of them are situated in the city of Mumbai. Okay, so one example if you can see here of Atash Behram, Udvada Atash Behram. Okay, I think it is in Gujarat. So this is their fire temple. Now, some important features of Atash Behram architecture, that how it is made, how it is built, etc. So the exterior is generally kept simple because idea is to hold a sacred fire and yagna ceremony rather than glorification of the faith. Okay, so the Parsis do not believe in glorification of their faith. No such designs, no such decoration on their walls. So the walls, the exterior walls are very simple, very plain, nothing is made on it. again, it is decorated with nothing, because they do not believe in any kind of glorification of their religion. Then they have an inner sanctum, just like a temple. Okay, in your temple you have the sanctum sanctorum. Okay, similarly in the Atash Bhairam as well, you have an inner sanctum where fire is kept. Okay, in the temples, if you remember, we have seen that in the sanctum sanctorum, the idol is kept. Okay, whatever the faith is, whether they believe in Vishnu or Shiva or Mother Goddess or Goddess Durga, etc. So the idol of that deity is placed in that sanctum sanctorum. Same is the case with temples of Parsis as well. So in the Atash Bhairam, there is an inner sanctum, and in that inner sanctum, they will keep the fire. Now the structures have vents for the smoke to escape. Of course, if you are keeping fire, smoke will be generated. Now you have to tackle that smoke as well, because if you don't have any vent or outlet for the smoke to escape, then the rooms of the temple will be suffocating. You cannot stay there for long. So proper arrangements has to be done in order to make that smoke escape out of that building. So vents are made in that temple so that whatever smoke is generated from the fire, which is kept in the inner sanctum, it will be released through those vents. Okay, and performance of ceremony is considered to be of the highest order and involves elaborate arrangements, and they are performed by the high priest called the stools. So this is important thing you need to remember, that unke priest ko the stools bola jata hai. Okay, the stool is not something like you say in the Hindi word, that the stool nibhana hai, you have to take care of this ritual, etc. The high priest of the Parsis are called the dastoors. Alright, so this was about the Atash Bhairam, that how the Atash Bhairam is made. No glorification, no decoration, simple structures. Okay, in this picture, if you can see, aapko walls pe koi bhi decoration nahi dikh rahi hogi. There are no such fountains, etc. No sculptures. The walls are really plain. Nothing decorative you can see in this building. So, no glorification at all. Clear? Now, here your medieval architecture comes to an end. Now, we will start with the modern architecture. Wasn't it simple? It was really simple. Okay. So let's make modern architecture simple as well. Here we will be learning about the Portuguese influence on Indian architecture, French influence, the British influence, etc. and contribution of some of the architects. Okay, so let's move on. First of all, let's see the Portuguese influence on Indian architecture in modern times. So the Portuguese architecture is also called the Iberian style of architecture. Okay, Iberian style of architecture is equal to Portuguese architecture. So the Iberian style of architecture introduced the concept of patio houses and Baroque style to express the strength of the church. So what is patio houses? Patio houses are cluster of houses attached to each other. The ones you can see in the Western world, okay, in America or in Spain, Italy, etc., you can see that there are a cluster of houses line by line, and they're attached to one another. Okay, one house is there, then you have another house, and all these houses are attached to each other side by side. So these are called the patio houses. And what is Baroque style? So Baroque style or Baroque architecture is a highly theatrical and decorative style. Okay, interiors, if you can see, it is really very decorative ceilings. Okay, you get the feeling of theater, theatrical art inside the big halls. So like you have come into a theater, big theater where plays are done. Okay, so this is called the Baroque style, very theatrical and decorative designs. Okay, patio houses are the clustered houses, attached houses. All right, so this was introduced in India by the Portuguese. Then it had elaborate detailed and theatrical design to create a dramatic effect. Theatrical design, as I told you, Baroque style. It is a part of the Baroque style. And the patio houses, you can also see a glimpse in Goa. Okay, in Goa, you can see a glimpse of the patio houses, which was dominated by Portuguese in colonial times, if you remember. Okay, so here you can see the examples of patio houses. Then it also involved use of contrasting colors as well. So these were the influences of the Portuguese architecture or the Iberian style of architecture. So in the exam, if you are asked about the Iberian style of architecture, do not get confused that I have never heard this kind of architecture ever. Okay, if you have read about Portuguese architecture in India, definitely you know that it is also called Iberian style of architecture. You should remember this. Fine. Now, some of the notable constructions under this Iberian architecture are the Zee Cathedral in Goa, the Basilica of Bom Jesus in Goa. Then you have the Castella di Aguanda in Mumbai, St. Paul's Church in Diu. Then you have the Diu Fort and Church of St. Anne Tlalolim in Goa. Okay, so you can see most of their constructions are either in Goa, Mumbai or Daman and Diu. Okay, so these places were dominated by the Portuguese in the modern Indian historical times. Fine. So let's see some of the features of these buildings. So this Zee Cathedral in Goa, it has been built in the Portuguese late Gothic style and it has a large bell called the Golden Bell. Then Basilica of Bom Jesus, jisko Holy Jesus bhi kaha jata hai. It is a World Heritage Site. Okay, World Heritage Site bhi hai ye. Ye Baroque style mein bani hui hai. And it has the body of revered Saint Francis Xavier. Okay, then you have the St. Paul's Church in Diu. Again, it is also built in the Baroque style. Baroque style, I will remind you again, Baroque style mein kya hota hai? Jo interior designs hoti hai, ceilings wagera, bahut hi heavily decorated hoti hai. Okay, so if you have visited any Goan church, etc., you will see such kind of architecture over there, wherein the ceilings or the walls are highly decorated. Okay, then you have the Diu Fort. So it was built on the coast of Diu Island and it has a lighthouse and cannons were placed on the wall. Then is fort may they have three churches. Okay, inside the fort complexes, they have the three church: St. Thomas Church, St. Paul's Church and Church of St. Francis of Assisi. And lastly, again, Church of St. Anne, it was also built in the Baroque style. So now after repeating a few things so many times, you would have come to a conclusion that what things are important from exam perspective that you need to remember. These things are the only things that you need to remember. These are just of the examples. Okay, they are notable construction: Cathedral, Basilica of Bom Jesus, Castella di Aguanda. ये सारी चीजें बस आपको याद रखने की, ये जो constructions हैं वो Portuguese ने बनाए हैं या उनके influence से बने हैं या उनका architectural style है इनमें. मेन चीज बस आपको पोर्चुगीज इन्फ्लुएंस में ये याद रखनी है. इसको इबेरियन स्टाइल ऑफ आर्किटेक्चर भी बोला जाता है. दे वर द वंस हु इंट्रोड्यूस द कांसेप्ट ऑफ पेशो हाउसेस एंड बरोक स्टाइल ऑफ आर्किटेक्चर. ओके, सो यू आर डन विद द पोर्चुगीज इन्फ्लुएंस. देन कमिंग ऑन टू द फ्रेंच इन्फ्लुएंस. सो इट वॉज द फ्रेंच पीपल हु इंट्रोड्यूस द कांसेप्ट ऑफ अर्बन सिटी प्लानिंग इन इंडिया. ओके, द फ्रेंच टाउन्स ऑफ पांडिचेरी एंड चंद्रनगर आर examples of the urban city planning, and they were built using the Cartesian grid plans and scientific architectural designs. That is, ab tak kya hota tha, there was no planning. Okay, chahe villages ho, chahe urban settlements ho, there were no planning in that case. But the French towns, for example Pondicherry or Chandranagar mein, they had proper plan. They had the Cartesian grid plan and they had the scientific architectural designs that how we will develop this city. Okay, हमें उसे ऐसे develop करना है कि in future कोई problem ना आए. Like for example, Harappan city structure की तरह, wherein you have the drains, okay, proper drains you had in each house, then those drains were connecting to the outside bigger drains. You had manholes at regular intervals so that if something blocks the drains, you can clean it. So such kind of scientific architectural designs were applied in these cities as well, cities of Pondicherry and Chandranagar. Chandranagar ab ho gaya hai Chandranagar, which is in West Bengal. Fine. They built imposing buildings as a show of power. Of course, every European did that. Then they also introduced the concept of anonymous architecture, which involves simple facade without much ornamentation or design, much like modern buildings. Okay, simple building. Okay, as we have seen in the case of Portuguese, they had the Baroque style, wherein you have a lot and lot of ornamentation, a lot of decoration, okay, inside your buildings. But in the case of French architecture, you have simple buildings, okay, simple facade, not a lot of ornamentation or design. Okay, so this was a kind of French architecture. Then these French also developed some coastal towns such as Mahe in Kerala, Karaikal in Tamil Nadu, and Yanam in Andhra Pradesh. Okay, so the main contribution of French architecture is that they introduced the concept of urban city planning in India, and they developed a few cities, and most important of them are Pondicherry and Chandernagore, wherein they applied the scientific architectural design. Clear? And their buildings were simple, not a lot of designs or ornamental decoration was there. Clear? So these are some of the buildings of French influence, a French building in Pondicherry, and this is the Church of Sacred Heart of Jesus in Puducherry. Okay, so if you go inside this church as well, you can see that it is not as heavily decorated as was the case, as was the Church of the Portuguese. Okay, then next is your British influence. So the British brought with them the Gothic style of architecture. It merged with the Indian architecture and resulted in the Indo-Gothic style of architecture. Gothic style of architecture may be 2-3 bar question aa chuka hai UPSC mein. Okay, so it was the Britishers who brought the Gothic style of architecture with them. Okay, now this Gothic style merged with the Indian style of architecture, and hence came out a new style of architecture that was the Indo-Gothic style of architecture. We will definitely be looking at the important features of Indo-Gothic style of architecture in the coming slides. Okay, so don't worry about it. Indo-Gothic style mein kya hota hai, kya nahi hota, explain nahi kiya hai. Hai aage ki kya features hote hai uske mein. Fine. Then Indo-Gothic style to ho gaya, but after 1911, okay, till 1911, Indo-Gothic style was the most prominent style of architecture. But post 1911, a new style of architecture, which was known as the Neo-Roman architecture, emerged. So till 1911, it was the Indo-Gothic style of architecture, which was prominent, which was very important. But after 1911, a new kind emerged, which was known as Neo-Roman architecture. Now, some of the examples of the British architectural buildings, like the Victoria Memorial in the left and the St. Paul's Cathedral in the right. Okay, see these. So these are the British architectural buildings. Fine. Now your Indo-Gothic style. Some of the features of Indo-Gothic style are that it is also known as Victorian style, and it is a blend of Indian, Persian, and Gothic style. Okay, teen styles hai isme. Indo-Gothic hai, iska matlab ye nahi sirf Indian aur Gothic hai, isme Persian bhi hai. Why? Because Persian style of architecture was also the most prominent architecture, architectural style of India till that time, till the arrival of the West Britishers or the Portuguese, etc. Okay, the constructions were extremely large and elaborate in their execution. You can see here they are really large buildings, unlike their counterparts. Okay, जैसे पहले हमने देखे थे temples थे, कश्मीर के temples देखे थे ना, छोटे-छोटे monolithic rocks से बनाए हुए temples थे. Then other architectures as well, if you can see standalone temples or standalone mosques. But these architectural buildings were really lavish, very big. Okay. The walls were thinner than in the Indo-Islamic construction. Okay, Indo-Islamic constructions में हमने क्या देखा था? The walls used to be really thick. Why? Because a lot of designs were used to be made on those walls. Okay, pietra dura. If you remember, floral designs, and inside those floral designs, gems and precious stones were inlaid. So that is called pietra dura. So unlike Indo-Islamic constructions, the walls were really thinner because उनमें इतना ज़्यादा आपको डिजाइन नहीं देनी होती थी. ओके, वॉल कार्विंग्स नहीं करनी होती थी. द आर्क्स वर पॉइंटेड एंड लाइक द कर्विंग आर्क्स ऑफ इंडो इस्लामिक एरा. ओके, इंडो इस्लामिक एरा में क्या होता था, आपको कर्विंग आर्क्स थे ऐसे, बट हियर द आर्क्स वर अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ पॉइंटेड. So here in this building, if you can see, I can give you a good example of the pointed arcs. Okay, यहाँ पे अगर आप arcs को देखोगे तो they are not of the hemispherical shape, they are in the pointed shape. Okay, so in the Saint Paul's Cathedral, you can see pointed arcs. Okay, so their arcs were pointed and like the curving arcs of Indo-Islamic era. One of the unique features of the Victorian style was the use of large windows. Of course, again, in the St. Paul's Cathedral, you can see the windows are really large. But if you remember, Indo-Islamic architecture, mein humne dekha tha, windows kafi choti choti hoti thi. Small windows used to be there. And again, those windows were having jali work inside them. Okay. The churches had a crucified ground plan. Then it adhered to advanced structural engineering standards of Britain, like use of steel, iron, and poured concrete. Okay, so these things were started being used under the British influence. Okay, until now what we have seen, जैसे कश्मीर का हमने पढ़ा था, wood use किया जाता था, iron use किया जाता था definitely कितनी जगह पे, Mughals के time पे mortar use किया जाता था. Okay, so but जो modern buildings में अभी use होता है basically the steel, iron, and concrete, this started with the British architecture style. Okay, so the Britishers introduced the use of steel, iron, and poured concrete on a large scale in India. Examples are Victoria Memorial in Kolkata and Gateway of India in Mumbai. Victoria Memorial already हमने पिछले वाले picture में देखा है. This is the Victoria Memorial and Gateway of India is there in Mumbai. तो दोनों और भी बहुत सारी buildings हैं. Just to give you a hint. Of Indo-Gothic style, ठीक है, तो विक्टोरिया मेमोरियल ले सकते हो, गेटवे ऑफ इंडिया ले सकते हो, ये दोनों के दोनों Indo-Gothic style से बनाया गया है, fine. Then is your Neo-Roman style, जो 1911 के बाद आया था, कि 1911 तक आपका था Indo-Gothic style, फिर बाद में ज्यादा इन्फ्लुएंस बढ़ गया Neo-Roman style का. So post 1911, the construction undertaken by the British Raj were done according to Neo-Roman style, जिसे Neo-Classical style भी बोला जाता था. Okay. Finest example, if you can take of the Neo-Roman style, is the architecture of New Delhi. Okay, Edwin Lutyens and Herbert Baker wanted a New Delhi, which would be opposite of the Old Delhi. Okay, Old Delhi was very congested. There was no space in Old Delhi. The lanes were very narrow. It was very unhygienic. The drains were overflowing, etc., etc. So Edwin Lutyens and Herbert Baker wanted that a New Delhi should be made, which would be just the opposite to the Old Delhi. That is, it won't be congested. Okay, its lanes would be very wide. The houses will be a distance apart. The drains will be very good. It won't be congested as well. So the architecture of this New Delhi was the finest example of this Neo Roman style of architecture. Okay, New Delhi ko Rome of Hindustan bhi bola jata tha. Okay, when New Delhi was developed, it was also called as Rome of Hindustan. Please remember this term. Okay, aapko exam mein pooch sakte hai, Rome of Hindustan kise bola jata tha? What is Rome of Hindustan? So it is New Delhi. Okay, features kya hai New Roman style ke? So the constructions were anonymous and without any interesting features again. Okay, so anonymous as in आपको उसमें कुछ ऐसी चीज नहीं मिलेगी जिसकी वजह से आपको पता चले कि ये किस रीन का है या हु वाज द रूलर ऑफ दैट टाइम. ओके, हु वाज द गवर्नर जनरल ऑफ दैट टाइम जिसके अंडर ये बिल्डिंग बनी है. सो ऐसे कुछ भी फीचर्स उसमें नहीं थे. इट वाज एनोनिमस. देन इट वाज अ कॉन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ ऑल स्टाइल्स ऑफ आर्किटेक्चर व्हिच मेड द स्टाइल कंजेस्टेड एंड क्रैम्प्ड द स्पेस ऑफ आर्टिस्टिक एक्सप्रेशन. ओके, सो इट इज सेड दैट इसने सब कुछ अपने अंदर मिक्स कर लिया था. Persian style, Gothic style, Indian style, other styles as well. So when all such styles are mixed together, what you get is a congested style. Okay, कोई भी एक style उभर के नहीं आती है उसमें से. So it is said that the style was congested and cramped the space of artistic expression. That is, you cannot express the architectural artistic features on those buildings because of confluence of so many styles of architecture. Okay, you don't know where to express your artistic expressions. Fine, कहाँ पे आप designs बनाओगे, कहाँ पे आप क्या करोगे, you don't know. Then simplicity, modernity and utility were highly compromised due to the hybrid nature of the constructions. Okay, as we have seen, जो buildings होती थी पहले की वो बहुत simple होती थी. Okay, उनका बहुत usefulness होती थी उनकी. Fine, जैसे कि अभी आप ये building ही देख लो. Okay, it is really simple. जो Indo-Gothic building है, it is really simple. इसमें कोई दूसरा इतना ज्यादा मिक्सचर नहीं है, आर्किटेक्चर इन्फ्लुएंस नहीं है. सिर्फ पर्शियन उसने यूज किया है. पर्शियन में क्या यूज किया है, आर्क्स यूज किए, बट स्टिल उसमें भी उसने ब्रिटिशर्स ने चेंजेस लाए हैं दैट वी वांट सम पॉइंटेड आर्क्स. पूरा हमें उसे पर्शियन नहीं बनाना है. सम इंडियन काइंड इज ऑल्सो इंट्रोड्यूस्ड एंड गॉथिक स्टाइल तो है ही. ठीक है, सो दिस काइंड ऑफ बिल्डिंग्स आर रियली सिंपल एंड इट हैज यूटिलिटी एज वेल. बट रोमन स्टाइल में क्या हो गया कि जब इतने सारे आर्किटेक्चरल स्टाइल मिक्स हो गए तो यू डोंट नो कि हमें आर्क कैसे बनाने हैं. चलो हम आर्क को थोड़ा पर्शियन स्टाइल से कर देते हैं, थोड़ा इंडियन स्टाइल भी कर देते हैं, थोड़ा हम उसमें गॉथिक भी डाल देते हैं, या ऐसे करके हम उसमें पॉइंट के ऊपर हम थोड़ा पिरामिडिकल शेप कर लेते हैं, तो वो सारा के सारा कंजेस्टेड हो गया. हेंस द सिंप्लिसिटी एंड द यूटिलिटी ऑफ द बिल्डिंग्स और कंस्ट्रक्शंस वर हाईली कॉम्प्रोमाइज्ड ड्यू टू दिस अंडर द न्यू रोमन स्टाइल. Okay, so if you can see, some examples are given. The Supreme Court of India as well as the Parliament of India comes under the Neo-Roman style. And this is Edwin Lutyens who had planned the construction of these buildings. So here in the Supreme Court of India, you don't know what this dome is kind of, you know, wo Indo-Gothic hai. या फिर वो पर्शियन है. सो किस स्टाइल से वो मिलता जुलता है, वी डोंट नो. ओके, वो हेमिस्फेरिकल भी है, बट उसके नीचे अगेन यू हैव पिलर्स विच वी डू नॉट सी इन द मुगल स्टाइल और द सल्तनत स्टाइल, या फिर इंडो गोथिक में भी नहीं होता बिकॉज इंडो गोथिक में पॉइंटेड आर्क्स होते हैं. राइट, सो इट इज अ मिक्सचर ऑफ सो मेनी आर्किटेक्चरल स्टाइल दैट वी कैन नॉट डिफाइन के कौन सी चीज क्या है. ठीक है, सो these two are the examples of Neo-Roman style. Then there was a focus on circular buildings. Its finest example is your parliament. Okay, then there was an overuse of oriental motifs to realize western architectural designs. The concept of upturned dome, as can be seen in the top of Supreme Court and Rashtrapati Bhavan, was introduced during this phase. Okay, so upturned dome mein kya hota hai, the central dome, look at the picture in the of the Rashtrapati Bhavan. Okay, jo central dome hai, the central dome is twice the height of the building. Okay, if you can see, this is the height of the building and uske upar jo ye dome hai, it is just double. Okay, height iski just double hai is building ki height se. So the central dome is twice the height of the building and the borders of the dome have miniature pavilion roofs. Okay, if you can see, small pavilions are over here. Okay, so you have miniature pavilions and chhatris. Okay, inko chhatris bola jata hai. The miniature pavilions are called the chhatris. Fine, so these are some of the features of the upturned dome. So Supreme Court ka jo dome hai, wo hai aapka upturned dome. Same is the case with your Rashtrapati Bhavan ka dome, jo ki upturned dome उसका फीचर है. ओके, बेसिकली डोम में क्या होता है, जो डोम है आपका ऊपर बिल्डिंग से छोटा होता है. ओके, नॉर्मली इफ यू कैन सी मॉस वगैरह है या दूसरी और भी बिल्डिंग्स है, उसके ऊपर जो डोम होता है वो आपकी बिल्डिंग की हाइट से छोटा होता है. बट इन द केस ऑफ अपटर्न डोम, द डोम इज ट्वाइस द हाइट ऑफ द बिल्डिंग. ओके, आपकी सुप्रीम कोर्ट की बिल्डिंग की हाइट यहाँ पे खत्म हो रही है, उसके ऊपर जो डोम है उसकी हाइट जस्ट डबल है. सो दिस इज योर अपटर्न डोम. क्लियर, एग्जाम्पल क्या है आपके अपटर्न डोम का, सुप्रीम कोर्ट एंड द राष्ट्रपति भवन. एंड दिस वॉज द आइडिया ऑफ एडविन ल्यूटेंस. ओके, द मैन इन द पिक्चर, ही इज एडविन ल्यूटेंस. फाइन, सो दीज वर सम ऑफ द फीचर्स ऑफ नियो रोमन स्टाइल. नाउ आफ्टर दैट, difference between Iberian and Gothic architecture. Okay, in case if you are asked in the examination to differentiate between the Iberian and Gothic architecture, या फिर आपको मिक्सअप करके देंगे, इबेरियन के अंदर गोथिक आर्किटेक्चर का फीचर डाल देंगे, गोथिक आर्किटेक्चर में इबेरियन, तो यू शुड नो द डिफरेंस, राइट, टू टैकल सच काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चंस. सो द मटेरियल यूज्ड इन इबेरियन आर्किटेक्चर आर ब्रिक. ओके, सो ब्रिक वाज द मेन मटेरियल, एंड अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट वुड वाज यूज्ड फॉर रूफ्स एंड स्टेयर्स. स्टिल इफ यू विल विजिट सम ऑफ द ओल्ड बिल्डिंग्स ऑफ दैट बिलोंग टू द पोर्चुगीज, ओके, so you can see that the ceilings were made of wood and the stairs are made of wood. Then what happened in the Gothic architecture? Red sandstone and quartz limestone were primarily used in the Gothic architecture. Now what are the structural variations between these two kinds of architecture? So the Portuguese continued with their Western traditions and did not introduce any structural variation, but when it comes to Gothic architecture, which is also called Indo-Gothic, इसको Indo-Gothic क्यों बोला जाता है? Because the Gothic architecture mixed with the Indian style. But in the case of Iberian architecture, it did not get mixed with the Indian style. It continued with their Western traditions. Okay, पूरे के पूरे अपने Western traditions से ही उन्होंने सारी buildings बनाई है, उसके अंदर कोई भी Indian feature उन्होंने नहीं डाला है under the Iberian architecture. But under the Gothic architecture, उन्होंने इंडियन स्टाइल को अडॉप्ट किया है, एंड हेंस इट केम टू बी नोन एज द इंडो गोथिक स्टाइल ऑफ आर्किटेक्चर. सो दिस इज द मेन डिफरेंस बिटवीन आइबेरियन एंड गोथिक आर्किटेक्चर. आइबेरियन ने कोई भी इंडियन ट्रेडिशन या इंडियन स्टाइल डेवलप नहीं किया है, इट वॉज द प्योर वेस्टर्न आर्किटेक्चर, बट गोथिक आर्किटेक्चर हैड सम चेंजेस एंड हेंस इट केम टू बी नोन एज द इंडो गोथिक स्टाइल ऑफ आर्किटेक्चर. सो विद दिस वी एंड विद आर प्री इंडिपेंडेंस आर्किटेक्चर. ठीक है, हमने अभी तक जितना भी कवर किया है ये हो गया हमारा इंडिपेंडेंस तक का आर्किटेक्चर. फाइन, नाउ वी विल सी पोस्ट इंडिपेंडेंस आर्किटेक्चर. ठीक है, सो पोस्ट इंडिपेंडेंस टू स्कूल्स ऑफ आर्किटेक्चर एमर्ज्ड, वन वॉज द रिवाइवलिस्ट एंड द अदर वॉज द मॉडर्निस्ट. ओके, सो दो स्कूल्स थी, एक थी रिवाइवलिस्ट और एक थी मॉडर्निस्ट स्कूल ऑफ आर्किटेक्चर. नाउ two important architects we are going to learn, but before that let's just briefly understand that what is revivalist school of architecture and what is modernist school of architecture. So the revivalist school of architecture used the visual styles or architectural styles that echo the style of previous architectural era. For example, we want to revive the Mughal style of architecture, okay, or we want to revive the previous temple architecture, the ancient temple architectures, leaving beside the modern colonial architecture. And of course, our freedom fighters etc. wanted to revive our glorious past, and hence they wanted to revive the architectural style as well that used to be there before the arrival of the colonial British architecture. Okay, so the revivalism in architecture is the use of visual styles that consciously echo the style of a previous architectural era. For example, Mughal architecture, Sultanate architecture, okay, the temple architecture of the Cholas, the Pandyas, etc., or whichever style you want. Fine, so this is the revivalist school of architecture. Then when it comes to the modern architecture or the modernist school of architecture, it was a style based upon new and innovative technologies, as we have seen in the case of the Britishers, who introduced the use of steel, the concrete, okay, etc. Okay, so in the modern style of architecture, you used glass, steel, concrete, etc. Okay. So the modernist school of architecture is basically based upon new and innovative technologies of construction by using such materials as steel, iron, glass, or concrete, etc. Okay, so this form, this idea is of the it says that whatever construction we made, whatever buildings we make, it should follow a function, that the building should have a function, it should embrace minimalism. Minimalism as in it should not be elaborate. Okay, the building should not be elaborate. That is, for example, if you can, if we can take an example of a bungalow or a building. Okay, in a bungalow, there lives one family or at most you can say two families. But in a building wherein you have around 50 flats, okay, a building with 50 flats on the same area where on which a bungalow is situated. Okay, on the area on which a bungalow is made, on the same area one building is also made. Fine, but in that bungalow, only one or two families are living. But in the building, around 50 families can live at a time. So this is embracing of minimalism and increasing its functionalism. Okay, and a rejection of ornament. That is, you do not believe in decoration. A lot of elaborate decoration, like in the previous times. Okay, normal jo residential buildings hoti hai, aap dekhoge, usme zyada kuch decoration nahi hota hai. But if you see some ancient constructions or some of the temples or the mosques or other such buildings, okay, jo pehle banayi hui hai, they have elaborate ornamentation. They are really very heavily decorated. But in the case of modern architecture, these are absent. Okay, you should have more of functionalism, that it should be of use. Okay, use to more people, and it embraces minimalism. That wo bungalow jis area pe hai, usi area pe aap ek building bana rahe ho jahan pe 50 log reh sakte hain, jabki bungalow mein sirf kuch 5-10 log hi reh rahe hain, even less than that. So this was the main idea of the modernist school of architecture. Okay, revivalist matlab kya hai, purane jo bhi style of architecture hai usko aapko revive करना है. And modernist में क्या है, आपको जो है innovative और new technologies से नई buildings बनानी है. Clear? The two architects, the two important architects of post-independence independent India that we are going to learn about is Laurie Baker and Charles Fourier. So Laurie Baker को architect of the poor भी कहा जाता था. Okay, he is also known as the architect of the poor. Laurie Baker is responsible for the revolutionized mass housing concept in Kerala. And in 2006, he was also nominated for Pritzker Prize, jisko Nobel Prize for Architecture bhi bola jata hai. Okay, so architect of the poor kyun bola jata hai usse? Because he revolutionized the mass housing concept. Okay, ki aap agar is architectural tarike se zyada ghar banaoge, to ghar aapke saste ho jayenge. ओके, आपको इलैबोरेट हाउसिंग नहीं चाहिए, इलैबोरेट स्ट्रक्चर्स नहीं चाहिए. ओके, एंड कुछ मॉडर्न तरीके आपको चाहिए, जैसे वेंटिलेशन प्रॉपर होनी चाहिए. आपको ये चीज भी ध्यान में रखनी है कि गर्मियों में आपको उस घर में कोई दिक्कत ना हो, घर जो है एनवायरमेंट फ्रेंडली भी होना चाहिए. ठीक है, दैट इज पहले की बिल्डिंग्स में क्या होता था, लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल ताजमहल का एग्जाम्पल से लो, मार्बल्स था उसका, वो इंडिया में अवेलेबल नहीं था. ओके, तो उसको इंडिया के बाहर से मंगवाया गया था. दूसरी और भी बिल्डिंग्स थी जो मेन मेन बिल्डिंग्स हैं, उनका मटेरियल यहाँ नहीं मिलता था. इंडो गोथिक स्टाइल में भी आप देखेंगे तो मेन मटेरियल से इट वॉजंट लोकली अवेलेबल, सो यू नीड टू ब्रिंग देम ऑल द वे फ्रॉम ब्रिटेन और अदर सच कंट्रीज. ओके, सो लॉरी बेकर मेड अ चेंज ओवर हियर. ही सेड दैट लेट्स मेक आवर बिल्डिंग्स एनवायरमेंटल फ्रेंडली एंड चीप एज वेल. सो जस्ट यूज अ लोकली अवेलेबल मटेरियल, मेक होम्स विद इट. And when these houses or buildings are made using the locally available material, it will be cheap, and hence the local masses, the poor people, can also purchase these houses, or they can build their own houses from the locally available material. So he revolutionized the mass housing concept in Kerala through his ideas and innovations. Hence it is, he is called the architect of the poor, Laurie बेकर. 2006 में उसको नॉमिनेट भी किया गया था प्रिजगर प्राइज के लिए. प्रिजगर प्राइज को नोबेल प्राइज फॉर आर्किटेक्चर भी बोला जाता है. ओके, सम ऑफ द फीचर्स ऑफ हिज आर्किटेक्चरल स्टाइल आर आई ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन टू यू. कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ एनवायरमेंट फ्रेंडली बिल्डिंग्स बाय यूजिंग लोकली अवेलेबल मटीरियल. देन ही इंट्रोड्यूस द कंसेप्ट ऑफ फिलर स्लैब कंस्ट्रक्शन टू रिड्यूस द कंजम्पशन ऑफ स्टील एंड सीमेंट. ओके, सो अगर आपको थोड़ा कंस्ट्रक्शन का नॉलेज होगा, दैट हाउ बिल्डिंग्स आर मेड, देन यू मस्ट नो दैट जब बिल्डिंग्स बनाते हैं तो स्लैब फिल की जाती है. ओके, स्लैब फिल की जाती है, उसके बाद आगे बिल्डिंग का काम बढ़ता है. सो फिलर स्लैब कंस्ट्रक्शन के इंट्रोडक्शन से क्या हुआ, जो स्टील और सीमेंट का कंजम्पशन है वो कम हो गया. ओके, अनदर इनोवेटिव आइडिया. ही ऑल्सो लेड एम्फेसिस ऑन वेंटिलेशन एंड थर्मल कम्फर्ट अरेंजमेंट. As I told you, okay, proper ventilation होना चाहिए घर में, and if there is a scorching heat outside, then the house should be enough, okay, good enough to absorb that heat. That is, घर में आपको ज्यादा गर्मी नहीं लगनी चाहिए, thermal comfort होना चाहिए आपको घर के अंदर या कोई भी building है उसके अंदर, ठीक है. So he laid emphasis on ventilation and thermal comfort as well. Okay, the next one is your Charles. Coria. Charles Coria is known for his work in urban architecture and spatial planning. He adopted modern architectural principles to local sensibilities and need. Okay, that is same like Laurie Baker. That is, agar aap India mein modern architecture, urban architecture develop kar rahe ho, urban buildings develop kar rahe ho, then it should meet the local needs and not the needs of the colonial rulers. ओके, सो इंडिपेंडेंस से पहले क्या होता था, ऑल द बिल्डिंग्स दैट वर मेड इन इंडिया दे यूज्ड टू फुलफिल द नीड्स ऑफ द कॉलोनियल रूलर्स. सो ही चेंज्ड द थिंकिंग, ही सेड दैट वी नीड टू मीट द लोकल सेंसिबिलिटीज एंड द नीड्स ऑफ द लोकल पीपल, सो द आर्किटेक्चर शुड बी ऑफ दैट काइंड. सो ही हैज डिजाइंड buildings like Madhya Pradesh Assembly Building, Mahatma Gandhi Memorial Museum in Ahmedabad, LIC Building, Connaught Place in Delhi. Okay, सबको पता है Connaught Place बहुत ही अच्छा developed area है, बहुत ही spacious है. Connaught Place is a very spacious area. Okay, so it has been developed or designed by the Charles Coria, and he was awarded Padma Vibhushan in the year 2000. Okay, लॉरी बेकर को नॉमिनेट किया था प्रिट्ज़कर प्राइज के लिए एंड चार्ल्स कोरिया को पद्म विभूषण दिया गया है 2006 के लिए. क्लियर? सो कुछ फीचर्स चार्ल्स कोरिया के याद रख लेना, कुछ लॉरी बेकर के याद रख लेना, एंड यू आर डन. आर्किटेक्ट ऑफ द पुअर किसे बोलते हैं? इट इज लॉरी बेकर. यस, इसको प्रिट्ज़कर प्राइज के लिए नॉमिनेट किया था. फिलर स्लैब कंस्ट्रक्शन इसी ने इंट्रोड्यूस किया है. ओके, देन अर्बन आर्किटेक्चर की बात आती है, वहां पे चार्ल्स कोरिया आ जाता है. कुछ बिल्डिंग्स इन्होंने बनाई है जैसे कि अभी मैंने आपको बताई ये सारी, और इनको पद्म विभूषण मिला है 2006 में. सो दीज वर सम इम्पोर्टेंट फीचर्स ऑफ पोस्ट इंडिपेंडेंस आर्किटेक्चर. पोस्ट इंडिपेंडेंस आर्किटेक्चर में आपको रिवाइवलिस्ट मॉडर्निस्ट स्कूल याद रखना है और दो आर्किटेक्ट याद रखने हैं, लॉरी बेकर एंड चार्ल्स कोरिया, एंड योर वर्क इज डन. So, in conclusion, you can say that thus we see that from the prehistoric times, art and architecture has found a unique expression in the life and leisure of the people of India. Greeks, Arabs, Persians, and Europeans, each of them has contributed in their own little way to the existing traditions. And the result is the splendid potpourri that is Indian art and architecture. Okay, so with this, your chapter on Indian art and architecture, sorry, Indian architecture comes to an end. Okay, architecture ke humne sare phases, sare periods cover kar liye hain, from the ancient architecture. Okay, jo humne rock art vagaira ya Harappan style of architecture tak se start kiya tha, till the post independence period. So we have covered all the periods, all the phases of architecture of India. Okay, so from the next session onwards, we are going to start with Indian paintings. All right, till then, study well.